Imagine a futuristic high-speed railway whisking passengers from Los Angeles to San Francisco in the blink of an eye. But what if I told you that this ambitious vision is now on the brink of failure? Today, we delve into the tumultuous journey of the California high-speed railway and uncover the precise reasons behind its astonishing downfall. The California high-speed railway, an 800-mile-long marvel, was envisioned to revolutionize travel, curb emissions, and boost the economy. Spearheaded by former Governor Jerry Brown and backed by the California High-Speed Rail Authority, CHSRA, and various companies, it aimed to transform transportation in the Golden State. However, due to some reasons, the project is failing again and again. The California High-Speed Railway project began with a lofty budget estimate of $35 billion, but as construction progressed, the costs soared beyond $45 billion. The massive financial burden placed on the state's coffers was staggering, leading to increased scrutiny and doubts about the project's financial feasibility. The cost overruns not only hindered progress, but also eroded public confidence in the project's ability to stay within budget. Navigating through an extensive web of bureaucratic hurdles proved to be a Herculean task for the high-speed railway project. Environmental reviews, legal battles, and regulatory approvals dragged on for years, resulting in significant delays. Lengthy court proceedings and debates over environmental impacts further slowed down the project's advancement, leading to frustration and waning public support. Securing the necessary land for constructing the high-speed rail tracks and stations proved to be a daunting challenge. Private landowners along the proposed route vehemently resisted the government's attempts to acquire their properties, leading to protracted negotiations and, in some cases, lawsuits. The demands for compensation for the acquired land were often exorbitant, escalating project costs and exacerbating financial woes. Over the course of the project, the California High-Speed Railway experienced shifts in key personnel and leadership roles, causing disruptions and mismanagement. Lack of a cohesive vision among stakeholders and decision-makers created confusion and inefficiencies, hampering progress. The project suffered from inadequate communication and coordination between various public agencies involved, leading to conflicts and an inability to address critical issues in a timely manner. The project struggled to secure adequate funding from both federal and private sources, leading to financial instability. Despite the initial grand vision, the railway failed to attract substantial financial backing due to its escalating costs and prolonged delays. As alternative transportation solutions gained popularity, potential investors and government agencies turned their attention elsewhere, leaving the project with limited financial support. As the California High-Speed Railway encountered setbacks and delays, alternative transportation options gained prominence. Ride-sharing services, advancements in electric vehicle technology, and improvements in existing public transportation systems offered more immediate and accessible options for commuters. These alternatives competed directly with the high-speed rail project, diverting potential ridership and diminishing the project's long-term prospects. Now the question of the video. Will California be ever able to make a high-speed railway for itself? The answer is simple. California needs to solve these issues to assure that they make this project successful. To tackle the issue of astronomical costs, California could implement several strategies. First, conducting a comprehensive cost analysis and reassessment of the project's scope could help identify areas where expenses can be optimized. This might involve reconsidering certain design elements or adopting more cost-effective construction methods without compromising safety or efficiency. Additionally, transparent budgeting and regular financial audits could ensure better financial management and prevent cost overruns. To overcome bureaucratic hurdles, California should prioritize streamlining the project's regulatory and approval processes. This might involve working closely with environmental agencies to expedite environmental reviews and find solutions that balance the project's goals with ecological concerns. Moreover, engaging with all stakeholders, including local communities and advocacy groups, early on in the planning process can help address concerns and build support, reducing the likelihood of legal challenges and delays. To resolve land acquisition challenges, California could employ a more proactive and collaborative approach. Engaging in constructive negotiations with landowners and offering fair compensation packages could ease resistance and expedite the acquisition process. Exploring the option of using eminent domain as a last resort while respecting property rights might also be necessary in cases where negotiations prove challenging. Clear communication about the long-term benefits of the high-speed railway to affected communities can help garner local support. To address leadership and management issues, California should prioritize stability and consistency in leadership roles throughout the project's lifecycle. Appointing experienced and knowledgeable professionals to oversee the project, along with forming a collaborative governance structure involving all relevant public agencies, can ensure better coordination and decision-making. Regular communication channels should be established to address concerns promptly and facilitate effective problem-solving. To secure funding for the high-speed railway, California could explore various financing models. This might include public-private partnerships, PPPs, where private investors contribute capital in exchange for revenue sharing or operating rights. Seeking federal grants and subsidies available for sustainable transportation projects can also bolster the project's financial stability. Creating a comprehensive and attractive business plan that showcases the project's long-term viability and potential economic benefits could attract more investors and funding opportunities. To compete with emerging alternative transportation options, California should focus on innovative marketing and promotion strategies for the high-speed railway, emphasizing its unique advantages such as reduced travel times, environmental benefits, and seamless connectivity between major cities can attract potential ridership. Collaborating with local tourism boards and businesses to promote the railway as a premium travel experience can also attract more passengers and boost revenue. By implementing these solutions, California can address the challenges that led to the California High-Speed Railway's failure and pave the way for its success. A strategic approach that prioritizes cost control, streamlined bureaucracy, effective leadership, and diversified funding sources can ensure the project's viability and garner public support. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to leave a comment about what you think of this. If you enjoyed it, leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos.